Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetTools.com, and today in this video I'm going to talk about all the camera equipment I use, the kind of tripod which I use, what kind of mic do I use, and all those things which actually help me make these videos which I produce for this channel, which is called GadgetTools. There are a lot of people who follow me, and there are some of those who are again other YouTubers, the fellow YouTubers, and they're also trying to build a channel and they need some help from my side in terms of whatever advice I can give to them. So in case you are one of them and you would like to know what kind of cameras I use, which mic I use, I will be talking about everything in this video so that you get to know what kind of equipment I use. And I will also give a link to that particular equipment in case you want to buy one. You can go ahead and buy that as well from the link which is given in the description of the video. And in case you don't find the link of that particular thing I'm talking about, you can actually reply to me through the comment section on this video, and I will reply you with a buy link in case you need it. So let's get started and let's start talking about the cameras. So when I started my YouTube career in 2012, I started using this camera, which is a camcorder from Sony. This is a Sony camcorder. It has a built-in GPS, it has some optical zoom, and this is a high definition camcorder which Sony actually gives you. This camcorder is right now discontinued, so I will give a link to some other particular device which is available, which is similar to this. One thing which is good about this camcorder is that it has a mic input over there. That means whenever you use this camcorder, you can also attach an external mic, because most of the time when you shoot these videos, either it is a gadget review video, it could be a prank video or anything, in case you have a small camera like this, this is something which is required, that you have a proper audio for it. And this is the first camera you can start with in case you want to do some small videos of gadgets which are going to be on a table and you would like to have a proper focus, high definition clarity. You can go for a camcorder like this, which is coming from Sony. So this is CX260VE, but this particular model is not available. So this is one camcorder I would like to suggest. You can also go for other Sony camcorders, which I will link in the description of the video. So this is one little camera you can buy. In case you don't have the budget to buy a camera, you start with your smartphone itself. You start with your smartphone and make sure that you have a tripod for your smartphone, not those Chinese ones, but something like this, which you have it. Yeah. So here we have a Arcon kind of a smartphone mount holder. This is very good in terms of the quality. It has these parts over there which are rubber. So these are rubber parts, and then you have the smartphone which can go over there. It can take up smartphone on of almost any size like this, like a Samsung S7 Edge. I can also try fitting a Mi Max over there. So see, if it can take a Mi Max in this particular mount, that means the mount is actually very good, and this is something which I like about it. So this is coming from Arcon, and this is not like a regular cheaper mount for your smartphone. This is a good one, and it has these rubber padding over there. Once the smartphone inside, it won't fall off easily, and you have another part over there of this particular mount in which you have a rotating kind of a ball with which you can adjust, and you can mount this thing on a regular tripod mount. So this is how it is, and this is something which you can get on amazon.in, and I will leave a link to this as well. This one you can use to mount your smartphone on a tripod, and let's talk about the tripod for the smartphones. So here we have it. So this is a small tripod thing. Make sure you buy the Joby one, which are the actually the good ones. This particular small tripod can actually help you mount a smartphone. It is kind of small, but they have an intermediate size in between this and this little thing and this big brother. So there is a size in between these two in the middle. You can go for that size as well. Otherwise, this is also not bad. You can actually place it on a table like this, and you can mount your smartphone over there like that. And once you have your smartphone mounted here, you can actually shoot anything using this small little tripod. So in case you want a flexible tripod which can actually be used anywhere, you can use these ones, and you can also tie these things around almost like a tree or something like a support holder kind of a thing. You can actually use it for multi-purpose, so this is something which is very nice. So this is a tripod which I use for the smartphones, and this is the one which I use for DSLRs. So this is the Joby bigger tripod, basically. I don't remember the exact name, and it comes with this metallic ball head, so you can adjust it as per your liking, like this. See, and it is very strong. It has this stabilizer over there so that you can see whether it is horizontal or not. This is the one you can use for a smartphone, and these are very flexible and very good quality of tripods. But this is very good because it can actually handle the weight of a DSLR with a lens. It is kind of strong, so I recommend it in case you use a DSLR and you would like to have a portable kind of a tripod to carry with you. This is also good, but the height is not much and you cannot increase the height of it. There is one more tripod which I use. This is one of the older one which I have. I have been using it for the last 3 to 4 years. This is a very good tripod. It comes from Sony and the model number is VCT-R100. So it is VCT-R100. You can read the model number in case you can read it. And this is also very good. This is made up of metal, very nice. This part is actually plastic, but it is very good quality of plastic. It has not broken in the last 3 to 4 years over my extensive usage. And this can be extended like this. You can extend the length of it, and this is like a 5 foot length from the ground you will get. So that is what which is good about this particular tripod. And this is very nice to hold a smartphone in case you have a mount like this. You can actually attach a mount over here and have a smartphone mounted over there, or you can have a camcorder mounted over there. You can also have a DSLR, big DSLR mounted over there, and this thing can actually take the weight of a DSLR as well. So this is very nice. These were the tripods which I wanted to suggest. Let me talk about the cameras more now. There is one more camera which I use. This is the Logitech 960 CE something. This is a high definition camera, Logitech one. You can actually do your live hangouts or live videos through this one. This is going to record a video in 1080p and it can broadcast that live. So this is a very good camera. In case you want a desktop or a laptop webcam which is full HD, you should go for this thing. And this is the one. It has mic over there as well, and it has these lights and this camera cap over there, which is also good. So I will leave a link to this as well. I do all my Google Hangouts when I do live session, Ask Abhishek sessions, with this camera. And this is the one which produces the yellow tint, not because the camera is actually bad, because somehow the light and the kind of environment in which I am create that kind of effect. And it has this flexible thing over there, so you can actually flex it as per your orientation. You can also have it at a slanted angle as well. So this is something which is very nice, good, and slightly costly as well. This will cost you around 7,000 to 8,000 rupees, I believe. Let's talk about some of the action cameras which I use. So I have a GoPro 4 which I got there in Taiwan recently when I traveled for that. So this is the GoPro Hero 4 which I have. Hero 4 it is, and it has the display over there. So you know about the regular features of this. I use this one as an action camera to record things. I just mount it, and it is not the GoPro which is more relevant here. More relevant is the GoPro accessories, what kind of accessories you go for. So there is something like this which is a third party accessory for GoPro. The regular accessory of GoPro will cost you much more, and you can wear this actually on your head like this. So you can wear it and then have a camera mounted here, a GoPro mounted here like this. So you can actually do that. So this is sorry if I look weird. So this is something which you can go for. I can give you a link for this as well. This is not the official accessory. However, there is one more GoPro mount which I have, which I got from a Chinese website. I will leave a link to this as well. This is something with which you can clip the GoPro anywhere. So I used it recently when I clipped it like this on my shirt, and I don't need to wear that GoPro thing which you wear it on your shoulders. So this is something which is very useful. This is very strong, and very sharp as well. Don't put your finger inside over there. And you can mount a GoPro over there. So what I did was I mounted the GoPro like this on this one and used this thing as a clamp to clamp it over there. And this was how the GoPro was recording all the time when I was using GoPro with this particular clamp. This is also nice. This is the third party accessory, not a GoPro official accessory, but a third party one. Okay. And apart from that, let me talk about some of the table tripods. So this is a tripod coming from Manproto. This is called Pixie. They call it Pixie. And this is very nice. In case you are conducting an interview and you have a table on the side, you can basically place it on the table, have a DSLR mounted on it, have a camcorder mounted on it, have a smartphone mounted on it. It can actually take the weight of a DSLR with a heavy lens as well, not like with a very big lens, but with the normal 18-55 or 18-135 lens as well. You can actually use a DSLR with this one and you can actually place it on a table like this and it will take the weight without any issues. So that's about the tripods and the cameras. Let me talk about the mic now. So this is one mic which I use. This is Audio Technica ATR3350. So you can use ATR3350IS, which is the newest model. Don't go for this one. This is the mono one, whereas the ATR3350IS is a stereo mic and it has a condenser over there. So this condenser will basically, what it will do is, whenever I was recording my hands-on videos in a noisy environment, this mic used to take the input, but there was a lot of noise. So this condenser over there can actually suppress the noise. I think that is it. These are the things which I use. I hope this video was helpful and I tried my level best to show all the equipment which I have. There is one thing which is left, I would like to show you that. So this is one mic which you can buy. This is coming from Blue. Blue is the company who make mic like Blue Yeti. This is the Spark Digital. You can use this one for recording your voiceover whenever you are doing it on your PC, or in case you are doing live hangout sessions. I use this external mic connected to my PC because my laptop mic is not that good, but this kind of a mic can give you very good sound clarity in case you are doing live sessions on your YouTube channel or in case you are doing voiceover. Although there is some problem, this metallic part over there, the metal cap came out on its own. I don't know why, but somehow it happened. So this is something which you should take care of, but sound quality is very good. You also have the option of adjusting the gain and the audio thing. And by the time you are recording any audio from this one, it has connectivity for the headphones. So you can connect the headphones and listen to yourself at the same point of time when you are recording audio from this one, doing a voiceover, or whenever you are doing a hangout and broadcasting live audio with the help of this mic. I do have a Blue Yeti mic as well that is there on that table. I won't be able to show you, but Blue Yeti mic is also good. It is the best mic you can buy, but it is costly. So these are all the things which I wanted to tell you. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks a lot for watching. In case you like this video, please hit the like button below. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below this video. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.